Okay, so good afternoon. Yan, magandang araw sa inyong lahat, sa aking students sa subject na Earth Science. And we come to a point where we have to discuss then about the magmatism and metamorphism. Okay, so on this part of our lesson, dito sa ating module, so makikita natin yung dalawa sa, let's say, graphic representation ng ano ba talaga ang tinatawag na magmatism at yung tinatawag nating metamorphism. Okay, so to proceed, we have to have a walkthrough on our module with our topic, first topic, magmatism. So objectives ng ating lesson for today is for you to be able to describe the characteristics of magma and identify the substances and elements present in magma and explain the processes involved in the formation of magma itself. Now, let us proceed in the first topic of our lesson. What is magma then? So we can identify that magma itself is composed of semi-liquid hot molten rocks located beneath the earth. Diba? Specifically nga, sinasabi nilang yung melted mantle rock and oceanic plate, on this molten state, when they solidifies, it creates igneous rocks. So, as makikita nyo dito sa ating module for today, they are commonly found in the surface of the earth. Now, to know the difference between magma and lava, magma and lava are both molten rocks. So, wag na wag po kayong malilito doon sa tinatawag na magma and lava. However, they only differ in location. So, ang magma po kasi, it is being found in the chamber of a volcano. Yan. While lava is found on the surface of the earth once the volcano erupts. So, napakasimple in simplest form. Magma, ang tawag sa molten rock, nasa loob po ng volcano, at lava pag nakalabas na. Ayan. Pag siya ay lumabas na, nagiging lava na siya. Now, magmatism is a process under the Earth's crust where formation and movement of the magma occur. So, where does this formation and movement takes place? So, kung makikita nyo sa illustration na to, let us scroll up a bit. May tinatawag tayo dyan na asthenosphere. So, huwag kayong malilito dyan. That is the area where the molten rock is underneath the lithosphere. So, yung lithosphere, yan yung crunchy part ng earth. Yan yung solid part rather ng earth. And sa baba niya, andun yung mantle at asthenosphere. Okay. So, to proceed, how is magma being formed? Yan. So, if you read all throughout your module, you'll find out this simple process, like in this diagram showing how minerals and rocks undergo partial melting. Diba? These solid rocks contains minerals, quartz, feldspar, biotite, tsaka yung tinatawag na hornblende. Yung first process niya, minerals that melt are quartz and some types of feldspar. Yan, katulad nung nire-represent ng background. And yung minerals naman, such as biotite and hornblende, generally melt last. So, unlike other substances, kapag yung mga minerals and elements sa each boulder of rock, sa bato, they have difference in melting point. Diba? Yun ang tinatawag nating thermal difference when it comes to thermal boiling point of matter. Now, melting in the mantle requires one of these three possible events to occur. Number one, very self-explanatory, you need an increase in temperature. Remember, temperature is the average amount of kinetic energy possessed by an object, and by virtue of that, by presence of conduction, diba? Conduction in mantle happens when heat is being transferred from hotter molten rocks to the earth's cold crust. Now, yung process na ito, ito na yung tinatawag nila, heat transfer. Kapag tumataas yung magma, it is often hot enough to melt rock it touches, and it happens at convergent boundaries. Kung asan yung mga tectonic plates. Yan. So makikita nyo dyan sa diagram yung partial melting ng oceanic crust sa crater. Yan, andun yung tinatawag na reservoir ng volcano. At yung mga cleavages na pinoproduce ng ganitong mga events ang tinatawag nating mga trenches or trench, di ba? Commonly makikita nyo to sa oceans. Marami ang presence niya sa oceans ng mga trenches, di ba? And at the sea level, ang makikita nyo na lang ay yung mga land formation na brought about by volcanism. So moving forward, number 2 is a decrease of pressure. Now, mantle rocks remain solid when exposed to high pressure. However, during convection, these rocks tends to go upward. Diba? This is known as decompression melting. This process occurs at the mid-ocean ridge and underwater mountain system. Alright, so para mas maintindihan nyo, yung tinatawag nating decrease in pressure. Halimbawa, when water or carbon dioxide is added to hot rocks, may tinatawag tayong flux melting. The melting points of minerals with the rocks decrease. If a rock is already close to its melting point, the effect of adding these volatiles can be enough to trigger partial melting, and it occurs around subduction zones. So tatandaan natin bakit palaging sa tubig nag-uukur siya. Remember, the seawater itself may presence po siya ng oxygen and ng carbon dioxide, diba? Kasi nga gawa ng mga thermal vents sa ating ocean floor, diba? So ito yung mga tinatawag na volatiles, mga additive volatiles, from the word itself, volatile, uncontrollable, or it can shoot an outburst, or it can catalyze a process almost instantly. So volatiles are being released from the crust overlying as thinosphere melts. So yon, habang tingnan niyo yung pointer ko ngayon, habang nire-release yung mga tinatawag nating volatiles through the crust, di ba? Yung mga dinadaanan niyang path o tubig, nagse-separate yung mga molecules ng iba't ibang gases. And it is, halimbawa, it causes oxygen or carbon dioxide in particular. It induces it as a byproduct na lang siguro yan. It induces the production of oxygen and carbon dioxide as a byproduct. Diba? Kaya nga meron tayong tinatawag na steam at that part. May mga parang fumes na makikita ka sa mga vents na yan. At tinatawag natin yan na flux melting. So on your first activity then, based on the discussion, at wag na wag yung kakalimutan, read all throughout your module in here. Napakadali po ng topic natin ngayon. Ang iisipin nyo na lang ay what causes molten rocks to come out of the surface of the earth, and in the first place, what are the elements or factors that causes them to melt or break down. So ganun lamang po, it's like a review on your previous science lessons ng mga nakarang high school days nyo. So be able to answer this activity then. So, based on the discussion, justify your answer to the following questions. You can read all throughout A, B, and C. Yan. Tapos meron tayong ditong, yan. Use the word magmatism as an acronym. Use each letter to represent the words that is related to this lesson. Saan yung hahanapin yung words na yun? Doon din mismo sa lesson proper natin sa taas, okay? So much for that. We move forward now to the second part of our lesson, okay? And for this one, I want you to accomplish first the first part of your lesson before you actually move forward to the second part of your lesson, which will be shared on the second part of the video, okay? So you'd have a great day and stay safe though.